Good afternoon to everyone from Khartoum, especially for those who are joining us from outside Sudan, either through YouTube, the channel of Comboni College of Science and Technology, Facebook Live, also through the Facebook page of Comboni College of Science and Technology, or through the link that was distributed through Jitsi Meet. For those who are following us through Jitsi Meet, just to say that we will have this presentation, and after, at the end, if someone wishes to raise any question, it will be possible. Even those who follow us through Facebook page or the YouTube channel, they can write their questions in the chat. The topic of this webinar is part of a research leading to a PhD about the application of the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management to Comboni Primary Schools, or Primary Schools of the Catholic Church at Khartoum State. Up to now, no scientific research has been conducted on the quality of Catholic schools in the Sudan, surely at the level of PhD. But even about the full application of this model, the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management to primary schools in this country. This particular kind of schools is quite meaningful in terms of numbers. In this state of Khartoum, they run 38 primary schools, but also in historical text, in historical terms, as the beginning goes back to the 19th century. So they have developed with the beginning of education in Sudan, as was shown in a previous webinar. This study described the application process of a contextualized tool to apply the European Foundation for Quality Management Excellence Model to these schools. So the object of the assessment of will be these schools of the Catholic Church that were started by Luigi Montiori in 1843, but they multiplied their number with the arrival of the leadership, under the leadership of Daniel Comboni. And this is one of the reasons why they are mainly known as Comboni schools, because of the contribution of this missionary to education in Sudan. Among those schools today, we have some of them that are especially known by their quality, like Sisters School Khartoum, Comboni College Khartoum, St. Francis or Villa Gilda. And we have a big number of schools that were especially meaningful because of their mission to provide education, especially to displaced and refugee people, under the program Save the Savable that was started in 1986. That program finished in 2010, and the schools of that program became community parish schools, schools under the responsibility of every single parish. As I said before, there are today 38, and they educate more than 19,000 students. So this is the object of our research. As for the theoretical framework, when we perform an assessment on schools, mainly in developing countries, most research are of this kind, production function research. And they consider variables like teacher-pupil ratio, instructional time, homework frequency. These variables are meaningful in developing countries, while instead in developed countries they are not so meaningful, because the diversity is much less than in developing countries. The diversity inside, or the variety inside every variable. Instead, in developed countries, most studies look at the organizational aspects of those of the school. In our case, we wanted to combine both. Some variables or aspects linked to this production function research type, and a second one also to consider the organizational variables. One of the models to perform this kind of assessment is the one provided by the Effective Schools Movement. But for us, it was not enough to make an assessment, but also to produce an improvement plan for those schools, to help those schools to develop. And this maybe was one of the weak points of the model provided by the Effective Schools Movement. And this is why we turn into the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management, because in addition to stimulate organizational learning and innovation, it provides also a basis for benchmarking. It's good as we have a group of schools with similar characteristics to have elements to compare between them. Also, these schools, they have a very strong social mission. And this model focuses on relevance to society in addition to quality. It is very holistic, as Catholic education is supposed to be, or an education in general. But between some secular models of education neglect the spiritual dimension. For Catholic schools, this is also important. It is based on internal self-evaluation or assessment, but also capable of external review. It takes into account diversity and avoids uniformity and involves all the stakeholders, even the students. So these are some of the reasons why we thought that the model provided by the European Foundation for Quality Management could be suitable for this work. This model, we can summarize it with these two designs. The first one is about the logic, let us say, the logical framework behind the model, which can be summarized with one word, RADAR. RADAR stands for results. It means the first step would be to define the results the school wants to achieve. Second, after results, is approaches, which plans are supposed to be designed to achieve those results. Third, deploy, the deployment of those approaches. Fourth, the assessment of the deployment. And finally, refined. No? It's not so far from the cycle of Demi, no? For those who are acquainted with total quality management. And then we have 9 criteria for quality. Those 9 criteria are divided into 2 groups in the model that was published by the European Foundation for Quality Management in 2013, even if it was elaborated the year before. Those 2 kinds of criteria are enablers and results. Enablers have to do with what the school does or the institution, and results with what the school achieves or realizes. Among the enablers, the model gives special importance to leadership and processes, products and services, while the other criteria are people, strategy and partnerships and resources. Results here, there are 4 categories. The results of the people. In the case of a school, surely we have to think of the staff, teaching staff, administrative staff, the students. Customer results, mainly the staff, while in customer results, we mainly think of the students. Results on the society. And then in the model speaks about business results, but of course, this kind of terminology is not so suitable for the educational environment. And there we speak normally about key results that include results, for instance, like the marks of the student. If we think of financial terms, the profit and loss balance, for instance. This model that was officially published in 2013 has been in force until 2019. Now the European Foundation for Quality Management has elaborated or published a new version of the model, where instead of 9 categories, we have 7, and instead of 2 blocks, enables and results, we have 3. The contents did not change too much. Also, the general vision, the general framework did not change too much. But the organization of these materials look now more with a different logic. First, we have the criteria related to the why of the institution. And surely, this is why we have here the purpose, vision, and strategy. And this has to do with the direction. So leadership does not have the role it had before. It's put along with organizational culture. In this new version of the model, then we have the how we do things, how the institution does things, and the criteria to be assessed are the engagement of the stakeholders, creation of sustainable value, driving performance and transformation management. As for results, things are still more similar, because even in the old model, for every criterion, there were indicators related to the perception, either the customers or the personnel, and the performance. Now this comes explicitly put in this way: stakeholders' perceptions and strategy and operational performance. As I said, it's not a deep change in the contents, but a kind of reorganization of the criteria. In this literature review, another element that was considered was previous assessment of schools in Sudan. And one of the best works I found was the book published by Fawzia Tahamahdi after her PhD. It was published in 2006, it's quite old already. She states that since the beginning of the 20th century, the Sudanese educational system has not been submitted to any kind of evaluation. So she does not apply the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management, nor Total Quality Management, but the CIPP model, Context Input Process Product model. Then, more recently, we have two articles published by Atayeb Yusuf Mohammed. In one of them, he does a kind of revision about previous studies on the application of total quality management to basic schools in Sudan. Surely, it's not specifically about the European Foundation for Quality Management model, but of course, total quality management is the wider, let us say, umbrella within which we locate the model of the European Foundation. And so when examining the application of the total quality management to basic schools in Sudan, he says that previous studies did not mention the way this model was implemented in terms of procedures, timeline, nor follow up or revise, nor the concrete model of reference that was used, nor the indicators of satisfaction of the customers. Then Atayeb Yusuf Mohammed, he concentrates his study on the application of total quality management to one of the best schools here in Khartoum, which is Al-Khobas, and conclude that it's possible to apply the procedures of total quality management to basic schools easily and with simplicity. And this implementation does not demand a special budget for it. These are important conclusions. Then in Sudan, we have some applications of the European model, but to private companies, like in Jat, for example. Some literature about that, but not about the application of the model to primary schools. In our case, it's not that we applied we did a research on ongoing process of quality management, but we elaborated a contextualized version of the European Foundation for Quality Management model, and we applied to a group of schools. In this sense, we can say that the research is innovative as for the methodology, but also in relation to the object of the research, because as I said, there is no research about the application of this model to primary schools in Sudan. In this sense, it can be a point of reference for the implementation of the model in other private or government schools of the country. The research strategy that was used was the case study. The reasons are here because the research is both explanatory and exploratory. We don't have control over behavioral events. The consideration of the context is very important, and we are focused on ongoing events. Nonetheless, we have elaborated a section of the literature review on the history of these schools, because the concept of quality cannot be separated from the identity of those schools, from their objectives, and from the historical events that have shaped that identity. So when, if we want to contextualize an assessment model of quality, also I think we have to consider history. There are some criticism about this research strategy, as of course you work with a little number of cases, and so you cannot generalize the results to a population. But the point here is not a population, but theoretical propositions. And according to Jean, this is the right strategy to describe an intervention and the real life context in which it occurred, as it will be our case. And also for meta evaluation, for us, it will be important to apply the model and then to assess the self-assessment process. The study, we combined both quantitative and qualitative methods, and we consider every one of the three schools in which we apply the process a single unit of analysis. So this was a bit the strategy used for the research. Then the propositions that we wanted to test, we have the following ones. No? The first one is that a contextualized version of the model can help assess the quality of Comboni Primary Schools in Khartoum State and elaborate an improvement plan. Also, this last aspect was important. Then there are different ways of applying the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management. Our proposition was to see that the questionnaire is the most suitable tool to introduce a contextualized version of the model. Then there are some aspects that should be considered in such a process. One is that before identifying the school for this case study, it's important to see their organizational culture. Certainly to plan properly with the school, the way of implementing the model, and to have the leadership of the school fully involved, motivated, work with them the aspects of communication. As I said, to contextualize the terminology, sometimes in the model we find some terms like business results that sound awkward or strange in the educational field. And then finally, it's important to link this process with the existing processes that are going on in the school. The steps we followed for this research, first of all, we presented the project to the director of the Diocesan Office of Education. And secondly, we prepared a questionnaire that was presented in a workshop with the school administrations of the different schools of the Catholic Church at Khartoum State. So that questionnaire aimed us at describing the culture of those schools, their openness and motivation to enter into a dynamics of continuous improvement. This workshop took place on April the 15, 2018. And then we selected three schools, all of them belonging to the Catholic Church, but with different characteristics. One was run and owned by a religious congregation. Another one was a community parish school, those coming from Save the Save World program, as we mentioned before, but was run by a religious congregation. And the third one was another community parish school that is also coming from the Save the Save World program, but run by a diocesan priest. So we wrote a message to the principals of those schools explaining the process and we opened a dialogue to see a calendar for the implementation of this assessment. And the first step, they had to create a quality teams with five members per team, because the idea for this kind of first exploration about the application of the model was to work with these quality teams. So we train them and we do the four workshops in which we fill together the self-assessment questionnaire. And at the end of that, they elaborated their improvement plan and then we assessed all the process. These workshops took place just before, let us say, the most difficult times of the Sudanese revolution. As you say, we finished in January. And in addition to the questionnaires, we did some interviews to triangulate information. At the end of filling in the questionnaires, the members of the team revised the results and identified the strengths and sub-criteria that needed improvement in their school. So for every criterion of, you remember that the model presents 9 quality criteria, every one of them has some sub-criteria. So these criteria or sub-criteria that were more in need of improvement were classified according to the urgency, the importance and or impact in the key results. And the third criterion was the availability of resources. So after doing this kind of analysis, the schools identify 5 areas for improvement that were this improvement plan. And as I said, finally, we assessed all the process. In the adaptation of the model proposed by the Ministry of Education of Spain, we see that the 2 criteria that are more meaningful or they have more weight are leadership, 12% of the final result of a school, and processes. Processes means learning, teaching, evaluating the students, preparing budgets, supervising, coaching or tutoring. All these are processes that take place in the school. So in our case, instead of keeping this kind of distribution of percentages, we consider that in Sudan, the qualification of the teaching staff, which falls under the criterion persons, and the quality of the premises, that falls under the category partnerships and resources, are really meaningful. And therefore, we put the same weight to all the criteria. Let us say we can consider this as a kind of contextualization, but it's also a way of simplifying the model for people that may find it quite complex, to work with different percentages. Instead, we kept the proposal for results. Certainly in a school, the results of the students, who are the main customers, have to have the greatest weight. So now I present the results of all this process. The first research question was, what are the particular characteristics of quality for a Comboni primary school? So the first aspect that was underlined, that came out from this assessment, was the care for the continuous assessment of the students. This aspect falls within the criterion 5, which is about processes, and in particular sub-criterion 5A is about well-designed processes. As we said, that while in many schools in Sudan, the full or the whole of the work is done on in the class, here they work a lot about the homework and the continuous tests to the students, periodical tests, to have a kind of continuous assessment. This is one of the characteristics of quality of these schools. Second one is the care for the facilities and material resources. This is under the subcriterion 4C, according to the model of the European Foundation. The three schools had an inventory of furniture and equipment. And I had already mentioned the research of Fauzia Tahamahdi at Khartoum State. And there they underlined that for the people to whom she distributed her questionnaires, the question of the lack of furniture, for instance, was one of the main factors that have a negative impact in the results of the students. Similarly, the research of the efficient schools movement in developing countries also spoke about the quality of the facilities. In 6 out of 8 studies, this variable, this factor, has relation with achievement. The third variable is the preservice training. Most schools in Sudan, they don't have people with a university degree. And for example, school one, as you can see here, 35 out of 39 teachers had a bachelor's degree. And the other two, in the other two schools, the number is less, the percentage is less, but the situation is better than government schools where a majority of teachers do not have a university degree, according to the study published by UNESCO in 2018. Another aspect that is underlined by some studies is the absenteeism of teachers. This is, for example, quoted by a study performed by Sofreco and requested by the European Union office here in Sudan. While in these schools, the absenteeism of teachers is very low, as we can see here. Another characteristic of schools in Sudan is the big dropout percentage. And instead, as we see here in the reports of UNICEF or even UNESCO more recently, in Comboni schools, and at least in the three schools we have examined, the dropout percentage is very low. The second research question was, how can the model help the school to know itself better? In the questionnaire we distributed to all the schools before starting the self-assessment process, we asked a description of the school. We asked them to describe their values and the attitudes that represent the culture. And if you go carefully through this description, you see that are quite simple. And those schools that went through the self-assessment process with the model, they produced a very much deeper description. Another characteristics of those schools that was improved by the process, that it was that the fact that those schools did not have a strategic plan or document where there was a statement about vision, mission of the schools. And this was, in fact, one of the aspects that they mentioned in their improvement plans, not the need of elaborating this kind of a strategic plan. This is the importance of this is underlined by the research of the efficient schools, but also UNESCO criticizes the lack of forward-looking resource planning in education here in Sudan. Also, if they are in this study done by Sofreco, Blue Nile and Red Sea, this, we find the same conclusions. Siddiq Adam Hammed, when he tries to understand the reason behind this, let us say, characteristic, he underlines the collectivism and performance orientation as parts of the two characteristics of the Sudanese culture that may be related to this difficulty for long-term strategic planning. The third research question was, how can the model help the school to produce its improvement plan? As I said before, no school have prepared an improvement plan before. And when asking them before starting the process to describe their previous process of self-assessment, we have this kind of situation. And this way, the TASE, three of the best schools in this point in relation to the other schools that participated in that first workshop with all the school administrations. No? In one school, one of the members of the quality team has already heard about the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management. When we put this previous concept of quality in let us say in relation to the 9 criteria of the model of the European Foundation for Quality Management, we find that there are many empty spaces, which means it is a way of seeing how the model helps to support a more holistic self-assessment. The fourth research question was, which variables explain the different quality between the schools of the example? So the at the end, after doing this kind of assessment in quantitative terms, so we find the result for every school, here, as you can see. As you see, for every school, we find two columns, because normally, I was trying to triangulate the data provided by the quality teams. And sometimes, for example, they say that there was something that, and then when you went to check if that thing was, there was no. But also the other way around. They were not aware of being or having something, a certain, for example, sometimes the inventory. There were the inventory, some people did not know. So they said we don't have inventory. So this is why I distinguished between the questionnaire filled by the quality teams and the questionnaire corrected with external evidence. But as you see, here the difference was quite small. Here it was bigger, but it's not so meaningful, no? That statistically speaking, this difference. And we see that the results on the staff is the point where these schools are stronger. As we said, trying to identify the variables behind the results of every school, we found something interesting, that two schools, school 2 and 3, at a certain moment they did a preparation camp with breakfast. So for 1 month before the final exams, or the national exams of the 8th year, they transform, let us say, the school in a kind of a camp, summer camp, where in especially school three was found a donor to provide breakfast, in addition to provide conditions for better study. And you see here the difference in the result. No, while here 50% of the students passed the exam, here we have 70, and here the result is amazing because from 44 they passed to 100%. As for school one, they never did this kind of summer camp, but the results were already very good. Here they explained that they introduced some people from an evening school that normally are weaker students. No? So this is a kind of element that alterated the results. About some input variables and their relation to quality. So here you have the final score according to the questionnaire. Let us say, if we can say that school one was the one that got a better result, but it's not bad to compare with the others. But it would be nice to compare this result with the same self-assessment performed maybe 1-2 years later. But certainly this school having a bigger number of students, they have more financial possibilities, and therefore you find a bigger number of teachers with a university degree or teachers specialized with university degree specialized in the subject they teach. So this has an impact on the result according to the model. It is not the same impact on the results of the general primary school certificate, where that summer camp, and there maybe it's not that we can know if the main element that helped the improvement of those results was the fact of having a place to study or the fact of having a breakfast. There are many studies about the importance of having good feeding to get better results. Yes, if we do correlations between these, we see, you know, that teachers with university degree element has a big impact, you know, good correlation with the results of the model. We also check the in-service staff training, and the school one that has better financial possibilities also is the one that has a greater care, also better possibilities for the ongoing training or development of the teaching staff. Yeah, of course, this has an impact on the salaries. The salaries of that school were bigger. We see that there is a kind of relation between the average salary and the results in the assessment, no, of the results of the assessment, more than the results of the general primary school certificate, where we had, as I said, that variable that had a very big impact. So after this kind of quick presentation about this research, we can state that the model offers a holistic approach to quality management and to the self-assessment of that quality applicable to Comboni Primary Schools of Khartoum State. As I said, there are some divergence between the results presented by the quality teams and those confronted with external data. But when we apply the Wilkinson Sign Ranks test, I could see that divergence was not statistically meaningful. The three quality teams were able to produce an improved plan with this tool, which is a big achievement. Also, when examining those improvement plans, you notice, no, this difficulty to connect basic strategic goals with the necessary strategies to achieve those goals. The members of the quality teams stated that the process was helpful and that it enlarged their understanding of the concept of quality. And then we could identify some of these characteristics of quality. As I said before, the stress on continuous evaluation of the students through homework and periodical tests, their open and dynamic concept of identity. Well, this is one of the strong characteristics I did not touch too much here in this presentation. And this care for the quality of their premises and their Catholic identity. When we speak about the difference in between the three schools of the sample, we have this kind of variables: the pre-service teachers training, in-service staff training, average salary and number of students. At the end, as I said, surely if you have a bigger number of students, you have more financial resources, more possibility of engaging teachers with better preparation and better possibilities also for their development. But then we found this element of the camps, no? That, as I said before. Then after doing this process, I noticed that there would be need to add in some indicators. And here I mentioned a list of examples of indicators that could give a deeper picture for every school. No? These indicators would imply direct observation of complete lessons that I did not do, and this surely would have enriched the self-assessment process. No? For example, to verify if the teacher, for instance, they use teacher-centered methodologies or child-centered methodologies such as the use of group teaching methods. These things you can ask, they will say everything yes, but it should be checked, no? And maybe or even they could check themselves. So a person different from the one who is teaching could, with a kind of table with these indicators, could check, no? That is, if it is teacher center or child center, and similarly concerning other indicators that are presented here. In similar line, similarly, we could also speak about to check, no, how many students they have a textbook, how many, if all the students they have a desk, the question of chalks, no, in these schools I am in a good situation in these terms, but in some other schools you find even that the teacher cannot find a chalk, no? Even concerning the premises. Further indicators could be elaborated to describe the situation of toilets, if there's electricity, there's no electricity. In our case, one of the schools had even a generator, and the other two, they had electricity. Not all the schools have electricity. Or drinkable water, for instance. So as final conclusion, we can say that with all these improvements, the addition of these indicators, this tool could become an excellent one to support continuous improvement processes in primary schools of Khartoum State. And now if anyone wishes to put a question, we open the opportunity. As you can see, we are streaming through Facebook and through YouTube. If anyone wishes to put a question, or put it there, and then we can even answer later on.